Well, there are several kinds of skunks, not just the black and white striped ones we are all so familiar with.
Researchers at the Field Museum have actually discovered three new kinds of spotted skunks. Until this new finding, there were just four species that were known. And as you can see in this video, the spotted skunk does a very unique handstand, earning it the nickname the acrobat of the skunk world.
This is just a great story.
It is.
I mean, let's enjoy it right now. Adam Ferguson is a small carnivore biologist at the Field Museum, the co-author of this new study, and he is joining us now. This must be sort of your lucky day, right? You're like, the spotted skunk made the news. How does this happen?
My thoughts exactly. I'm really excited it did, and it's all about the skunks, and so this is great. I appreciate the coverage and you having me here.
All right, so how did this whole research come about? Because it can't be easy to put research like this together, especially when you're talking about something like a spotted skunk that people know very little about.
Right, yeah, so it was many years in the making, more than I'd like to admit, but we worked with many scientists and many other collections to accumulate a series of samples because we were interested in understanding how many species of spotted skunks there actually were. And like you mentioned earlier, there were thought to be four species, but when we dug much deeper into the genetic data with specimens from all the way from the Yucatan Peninsula to Costa Rica, north to Oregon, we actually found that there were actually three previously unrecognized species based on the genetic data.
Okay, so we're looking at this nighttime video of the spotted skunk, not only doing a handstand, but also, I mean, almost like strutting its stuff like a peacock would. What in the world is going on there?
Yeah, it's part of its warning mechanism. So unlike the peacock, he's not trying to attract a mate. He's actually trying to warn off another predator or would-be enemy, I would suppose. And so they do this pre-warning where they do the handstand and stand up, puff up the tail as it is really large. And basically it's a threat that says, leave me alone. I have a weapon. I'm not afraid to use it.
Oh, boy. Okay, do they then laugh and run away and point their finger at you? Okay, so here's my next question. For people that are looking at this and thinking, could I spot one of these, like, in my backyard? Is it in the Midwest? Where would we see one of these?
Yeah, the closest you could see one, unfortunately, they're not in Illinois. We have the single skunk, the striped skunk, but they would be in Iowa and Missouri. So they're very common in the Ozark Mountains, for example. That's the Appalachian spotted skunk, which is one of the two that we split off based on the genetic data. Hmm.
So, Adam, what do we do with this new knowledge about spotted skunks?
Yeah, I mean, I hope, you know, one of the species is actually being considered listed as endangered under the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Act. It was a subspecies that was petitioned, and now it's a full species, which basically means it's more evolutionarily distinct than we thought. So some of them require additional protection and studies, but hopefully what I'm hoping, especially with this kind of exposure, is that other people get interested and excited and go to find out more about these new species that we haven't studied because we've always thought they were the same species.
So interesting.
So, Adam, I got to ask you, because we only have about 30 seconds left.
Sure.
What's the story with the hippo over your shoulder? I don't think we've ever done a live interview where a guest looks like he's being eaten by a mounted hippo.
Sorry, that, you know, the Field Museum, we do mammals from small and stinky to big and stinky. So that is a hippo mount that is actually it's a fake mount of a hippo that we have in here.
All righty, I'm glad you didn't encounter that thing in the wild on a research trip and bring it home. I don't think the Field Museum encourages that sort of thing.
No, definitely not.
What a team player. All right, very cool to talk to you. Adam Ferguson, who worked on this research on the spotted skunk, we appreciate your time, sir.
Thank you very much.
Come back anytime.
Thank you. I really appreciate it.